Hello everyone, I am Preet and welcome to Relevant Myths. Human civilization all around the world has always been a male-dominated society, some more than others, but it is unanimous that each and every culture is patriarchal in nature and has exploited women every step of the way. And the Indian civilization is no different. Now, it is true that Indian culture has always had a remarkably big place for women and is more feminine than most other cultures, but that doesn't take away the fact that there have been innumerable accounts of women being exploited in various areas. In this video, I will discuss four of the most significant and controversial events in Indian mythology surrounding exploitation of women, which clearly reflect how male-dominating and women-oppressing our society was and in fact still is today. These events will definitely make you think about how there is a deep-rooted bias against every woman, which reflects clearly in the rules of our society, which are female-oppressing at their very core. I will describe all the events first and then we will discuss them in detail afterwards. So, let's get started. Yudhishthir gambling away Draupadi. Yudhishthir was called Dharmaraj, meaning knower and follower of Dharma, but he only had one weakness and that was gambling. All Kshatriyas enjoyed gambling and Yudhishthir was no different, and even Dharma allowed it, as it was said that a Kshatriya cannot refuse a call to yudh or battle and dyut or gambling. So Yudhishthir had accepted Duryodhan's and Shakuni's invitation to play the game of dice with them in Hastinapur. But in the game, one after the other, Yudhishthir kept losing bets and ultimately ended up losing his entire kingdom of Indraprastha. But he couldn't give up. The offer was clear. One win and he would get everything back that he had lost. So he decided to gamble his own brothers in order to win back his losses. But all in vain, as he lost all his four brothers to Duryodhan. Still not able to let go of what he had lost, he decided to gamble himself in order to win back all his property as well as his brothers. And again, like every other time, Duryodhan won and Yudhishthir lost himself to him. Shakuni then told Yudhishthir about a last chance where he could win back everything he had lost. And that chance was by gambling the five brothers' common wife Draupadi. Yudhishthir agreed and betted Draupadi also. But once again, Yudhishthir lost and Draupadi became Duryodhan's slave. When Draupadi heard the news of her bet and loss, she was enraged.
और मुझे हार जाने वाले उस जुआरी से ये पूछो कि वो पहले अपने आप को हारा था या मुझे?
But Dushasan forcefully dragged her to the Kuru court and presented her to Duryodhan. On arriving there, Draupadi questioned Yudhishthir that whom had he gambled first, her or himself? Because a person who has lost himself has no right to anything or anyone else.
आपको तो शास्त्रों का ज्ञान है पितामह। मुझे बताइए, जो व्यक्ति स्वयं अपने को जुए में हार चुका है, वो कौन होता है? किसी और की स्वतंत्रता, किसी और के आत्मसम्मान को दांव पर लगाने वाला? मैं अपने प्रश्न का उत्तर मांग रही हूँ पितामह, और आपका ये लज्जित मौन मेरे इस प्रश्न का उत्तर नहीं हो सकता। यदि पत्नी पति की संपत्ति होती है, तो जब मेरे पति अपने को हारे, उसके साथ मुझे भी हार गए, तो फिर मैं दांव पर कैसे लगी? और यदि पत्नी पति की संपत्ति नहीं, तो मेरे पति मेरी आज्ञा लिए बिना मुझे दांव पर कैसे लगा सकते हैं? इस वंश की मर्यादा इस विषय में क्या कहती है?
She further asked all the members of the Kuru court, including Bhishma, Drona, Krip and Vidur, that with what right did Yudhishthir gamble her? She didn't belong to anyone. She was a free woman, and that a husband doesn't have any right to gamble away his own wife. But nobody listened to her, and those who did told her that it was a long believed tradition that a husband has rights on his wife एंड दैट व्हाट हैपेंड वाज अकॉर्डिंग टू धर्म।
युधिष्ठिर ने द्रौपदी को दाव पर लगाकर अच्छा नहीं किया, परंतु पत्नी पर पति का अधिकार तो सिद्ध है।
Then Duryodhan offered her to sit on his lap and become his wife, while Karn taunted that a woman who already had 5 men wouldn't mind a 6th one and proceeded to call her a whore.
ये 5 तो तुम्हारी रक्षा नहीं कर पाए, इसलिए आकर मेरे मित्र दुर्योधन की गोद में बैठ जाओ। 5 पतियों वाली तो तुम पहले ही से हो, तो छठे का हाथ पकड़ लेने में हानि क्या है? जो स्त्री 5-5 पुरुषों के साथ रहती हो वो पत्नी नहीं, वेश्या होती। और वेश्या का मान क्या और अपमान क्या? ये यहां नग्न भी लाई जाती तब भी अनुचित ना होता।
अनेबल टू टेक द्रौपदी'स रूट डिनायल, Duryodhan then ordered Dushasan to disrobe her in front of the entire court as a punishment, which Dushasan followed and began to unwrap her sari.
चल उतार अपने वस्त्र। अरे उतार, इधर छाती कहाँ है? चल इधर, आ इधर,
छोड़ दे मुझे।
The sobbing, half-naked Draupadi kept chanting the name of Govind, and ultimately her friend Krishna saved her when nobody else did. Ram banishing Sita. King Ram was walking around the city of Ayodhya in a disguise in order to know the actual day-to-day condition of the common folk, which he would not be able to see while being in his palace. While roaming around the river banks where the washerman lived, he saw a huge quarrel going on between a husband and a wife, and a lot of people were around watching the drama. Ram also went near in order to find out what happened. One person informed him that the wife had left the house at night in order to go to her maternal house in another village, but couldn't reach there as she was robbed by some dacoits. So she returned back here, but her husband said that he will not accept any woman as his wife who was in company of other men during a full night. So he kicked her out of the house and refused to accept her back. Ram then heard the husband saying, "Our King Ram may be great enough to accept back a woman who spent time with another man, but I am not him. You will never ever have entry to my house. Get out." Ram was absolutely shocked to hear that. He said in his mind, "Sita is as pure as fire, and she even gave the Agni Pariksha in order to prove her chastity to the entire world, but still my own people of Ayodhya don't believe her to be pure."
वो रावण जैसे महापापी के घर में 10 महीने रहकर आई, और हमारे राजा राम को उस स्त्री से इतना मोह है कि ना उसे केवल घर में रखा बल्कि अपने साथ सिंहासन पर भी बिठा लिया। अरे क्या आवश्यकता थी इसकी?
एक ने तो यहाँ तक कहा कि सीता ने सूर्यकुल के राज सिंहासन को दूषित कर दिया है।
संसार में एक से एक बढ़कर सुंदर राजकुमारियां हैं, किसी से भी विवाह कर लेता।
वो तो महाराज के लिए भी कह रहे थे कि सीता के मोह ने उन्हें निर्बल कर दिया है।
परंतु भैया, जब कोई पुरुष किसी स्त्री के मोह जाल में फंसता है ना, तो उसकी यही दशा होती है। वो अपनी आंखों से देखकर भी विष पी लेता है।
उसे राजमहल में ही रखकर अपने पूर्वजों की कीर्ति को मिट्टी में मिला रहे हैं।
अरे भैया, आज तो एक गांव में हुआ है, कल नगर में भी यही दुराचार फैल जाएगा और सब लोग रानी का उदाहरण देंगे।
He returned to the palace and instructed his spies to find out about the feelings of the common folk about their queen Sita. The spies returned and said that there was a growing talk in the folk regarding Sita's chastity and Ram's decision to accept her. Many people said that they never saw her take the Agni Pariksha, so how can they be sure? Now, the queen is considered as the mother of the kingdom. And here, the people were gossiping about the queen's character, which meant that they didn't respect her and weren't happy with her. And that was unacceptable. A queen's character and morality should be above every single citizen of the kingdom. That's what the rules of the Raghukul said. So, Ram told his brother Lakshman to take his pregnant wife Sita out of the borders of Ayodhya and leave her in a forest, and also instructed him to tell her not to enter the kingdom and ever reveal to anyone that she was Ayodhya's queen. Parshuram killing his own mother Renuka. The great sage Jamadagni lived with his extremely loyal wife Renuka. They had 5 sons, out of which the 5th one was Ramabhadra, who, because of his extreme devotion to Lord Shiva, received an axe from him and was thus called Parshuram. One day, Renuka was at a pond fetching water, and suddenly she saw the reflection of a very handsome celestial being flying above her in the pond water. She started admiring the being's beauty and dreamed about him for just a moment. Immediately, she lost her chastity as she thought about another man, even though just for a moment. His husband, sage Jamadagni, with his great meditative powers, found out about her loss of devotion towards him and got enraged. He ordered his 4 elder sons to kill Renuka. The sons were confused between following their father's orders and killing their own mother. Ultimately, they refused to kill their mother. Jamadagni then got more angry and then called Parshuram, who was meditating in the forest, and ordered him to kill Renuka. Without a single moment of hesitation, Parshuram immediately followed his father's command and cut her own mother's head with his axe. Jamadagni then told him to kill all his 4 brothers too who disobeyed him. Parshuram again immediately followed the command and killed all his brothers. Jamadagni was very satisfied with Parshuram's devotion and granted him a boon.
मुझे तुम पर गर्व है पुत्र, तुमने आज्ञाकारिता का इतिहास रचा है। मैं बहुत प्रसन्न हूँ, अत्यंत प्रसन्न हूँ। इस आज्ञाकारिता के पुरस्कार के रूप में आज तुम मुझसे कुछ भी मांग सकते हो, कुछ भी मांग लो पुत्र, जो चाहे मांग लो। मैं आज तुम्हें हर वो वस्तु दूंगा जिसका देना मेरे वश में है, मांग लो पुत्र।
परशुराम रिक्वेस्टेड हिज फादर टू ब्रिंग बैक हिज मदर एंड 4 ब्रदर्स बैक टू लाइफ, व्हिच जमदग्नि एग्रीड टू एंड ब्रॉट देम बैक फ्रॉम द डेड। Rishi Gautam cursing Ahilya. Created by Brahma himself, Ahilya was considered as the most beautiful woman ever. But she was gifted to a much older Rishi Gautam. One day, Indra, the king of the Devas, learned of Ahilya's extreme beauty and arrived at her residence when Rishi Gautam was away in order to have sexual intercourse with her. Now, there are multiple varied versions of the story after this. According to some versions, Ahilya was violated and raped by Indra against her wishes. While in some versions, Indra was disguised as Rishi Gautam himself and deceived Ahilya into giving in. Some versions tell a different story, where Ahilya was craving affection from his husband, but the ascetic Gautam had refused her. So, when Indra arrived, even though she saw through the disguise, she ignored the deception and continued to make love with him. And in another version also, she saw through the disguise, but this time, owing to her own lust, she had sex with Indra and later even requested him to save her from her husband's wrath. Moving on, varying from version to version, Gautam found out about the incident between Ahilya and Indra, and in all versions, irrespective of her being violated or her being a victim of deceit or her being fragile because of his own lack of affection towards her, Gautam caused Ahilya to become invisible for thousands of years or turned her into a stone for thousands of years. And also he caused Indra to lose his testicles and also his throne in Swarg.
सहयोग दिया है।
वो आपका वेश धारण कर आया था, मैं समझी आप ही हैं।
किंतु वो मैं नहीं था, अब तो ये तू जान चुकी है।
मैंने जीवन भर आपकी सेवा की है।
इस एक क्षण ने तेरे सारे जीवन की सेवा पर पानी फेर दिया।
मुझे क्षमा कर दीजिए स्वामी, मुझे क्षमा कर दीजिए, मुझे क्षमा कर दीजिए स्वामी।
क्षमा? कदापि नहीं। तेरा शरीर अपवित्र हो चुका है, तेरी आत्मा अपवित्र हो चुकी है। जाओ, मैं तुझे शाप देता हूँ, इस क्षण तू पत्थर बन जा।
The curse finally was broken when Ram passed through the same house and Vishwamitra told him Ahilya's story. Ram considered Ahilya pious and touched her feet, which ended her curse. After hearing about Ram saving Ahilya, Rishi Gautam also accepted her back and they started living together again. So, these were the four controversial events from Indian mythology surrounding women, and after knowing about them, it is very clear why they were included. It is obvious from all these stories that there is a very hard line which is considered as acceptable behavior for women regarding their chastity and freedom. And if the woman crosses that line even for just a moment, like Reduka did when she just thought about another man, the husband is angry and even goes as far as ordering to kill her. Now, Indian literature is full of metaphors and double meanings, so it is also important to look at the metaphorical aspect of the story. The story of Jamadagni ordering to kill Renuka sends a crystal clear message that women are meant to be 100% dedicated to one man, and if she even thinks about somebody else, the consequences will be life-threatening. Something similar is found in the Ahilya story as well. Now there are so many versions of the same story that one has to wonder why did every other person who retold the story had to change it. These many versions with this much difference in the main motivation of Ahilya just reflects how confused everyone was regarding her story. In most versions written earlier in time, Ahilya is not deceited or violated and she knowingly accepts Indra. But when new versions keep coming, Ahilya's story is slowly converted to her either being unaware of Indra or just plainly being raped by him. So, this shows us that people were uncomfortable with Ahilya knowingly being with Indra, as that was creating quote-unquote wrong example in the minds of the people regarding the story. So, slowly, the story itself changed to Ahilya not even knowing that she had again, quote unquote, done wrong. Still, Gautam's punishment remained almost the same in all versions, meaning that it doesn't even matter how she was with another man. Once it happened, the woman is automatically to blame and any punishment given to her is justified. That is exactly the same mindset right now also. Even when a girl or a woman has been brutally raped, most people don't even care about the situation and just automatically blame the woman, and suddenly she becomes the recipient of all the social backlash. Again, Draupadi's story is also completely relevant today. Our culture has repeatedly established that a husband has rights on his wife, and Yudhishthir gambling Draupadi even showed that he literally owned her. Now, Draupadi was a fiery personality, so she questioned the society about the rules and said that she didn't belong to anyone and that her husband doesn't own his wife. Yet, she was shut down by everyone and was further shamed for her quote-unquote lack of respect. This is the reason why most men believe that they own the woman and can do anything to them, which is the reason for so much domestic violence in India. And seeing what Draupadi had to go through for speaking up against the norms, other women are just afraid of the consequences and have slowly even themselves accepted the dominance of men upon them. Similarly, we see in Sita's story that more importance is given to rules and norms of the society rather than the woman herself. Ram considered the gossip of people more significant than his own knowledge that Sita was completely pure. He banished her fully well knowing that she was pure and gave more importance to the rules of the Raghukul and people's voice. Same happens today also. Women are considered less important than work and they are always given the second priority. And also, popular social opinion about them is also taken more seriously because society is more important than the woman and the truth. What the mass believes is correct, everything else is wrong. These mentalities are what result in the diminishing status of women in our society, and from these stories, it is very clear why our society is what it is right now. Because it has always been like that from the start. This is nothing new. Women have been subjected to patriarchy from the inception of human civilization, and even today in the 21st century, we are not sure whether we have improved the least bit from our continuous failures as a society where there is acceptance and respect for everyone. So this was the video, everybody. Please like the video and more importantly, comment your own views and opinions about this topic down in the comment section below. I reply to almost every comment so we can have a good interactive discussion there. Also, don't forget to subscribe to Relevant Myths if you like my content, and please share this video to as many people as possible. Thank you for watching and have an awesome day.